Hi, in this tutorial, we'll explore the concept of spline orientation, which is the up direction at each point of the spline. Take these two splines. They appear identical, but these cubes behave differently when traversing them. The reason for this discrepancy lies in the orientation of the splines. By activating the orientation gizmo, one can see the orientation of each spline. Notice how it turns in the spline on the right, while it constantly points up in the spline on the left. Every spline has an orientation setting that defines how the orientation of its points is computed. The simplest option is no orientation at all. Next, we have static orientation. If we select a control point and change its rotation, the orientation of the spline changes locally, only for the segments before and after the rotated control point. The default orientation setting is dynamic. Notice how this setting makes the whole spline orientation change when I rotate the first or last control point. Rotating a control point in the middle does not affect the orientation. To better understand how dynamic orientation works, you need to understand orientation groups. An orientation group is a set of segments for which dynamic orientation is computed. By default, all segments of a spline are part of the same group. Every group is defined by two control points, one at its start and one at its end. These delimiting control points are called orientation anchors. To distinguish them, either look for the anchor icon in the hierarchy view or activate the orientation anchor gizmo in the scene view. Now let's get back to our spline. Modifying the rotation of an orientation anchor changes the orientation for the whole group. Modifying the rotation of any non-orientation anchor does not affect the orientation of the spline. I will make four orientation groups by setting the orientation anchor setting to true for these control points. Notice how turning an anchor modifies the orientation of only the groups it defines. Modifying dynamic orientation via control point rotation has its limitations. Orientation turns up to only 180 degrees. If you want further rotation, you need to use the swirl setting. Let's select an orientation anchor and change its swirl setting. Let's set it to anchor group absolute. And now let's set the turn setting to 4. Notice how the orientation changes evenly along the group's length. The other values for swirl do the following. Anchor group distributes the turns not based on the distance, but based on the number of segments. In other words, if our group has 2 segments, each one will have half the turns. The segment value makes the turns be applied to each segment individually, instead of distributing them across the entire group. Finally, let's explore the orientation baking. This operation changes the transform of a control point to match the orientation of the spline at that point. This baking can be done manually via the button or automatically by setting bake orientation to true. I hope this video was helpful. Please subscribe to not miss future videos, and have a nice day.